Well, I think we can agree never.
Not gonna happen. Yeah, I think there's a lot of connecting the dots that isn't necessarily maybe the most logical, straightforward conclusion. You know, you see a symptom and you might automatically think one thing, but then, you know, look at the patient's history and make different inferences based on, you know, who they are and what their life experience is, like what their diagnosis might actually be.
Which in theory, AI should be able to do, but if it were to do it, it would probably take a really, really, really long time. Because at the stages where we are now, we are not able to do that, honestly. Like the placebo effect, there's so many different things that we don't really understand yet, and we're still discovering recently. And depending on your moral attitude, it can also affect your immune system. And so if you're just talking to a robot, maybe you wouldn't feel as
comfortable cared for.
Yeah, or special, which we as humans may need to feel special.
Ich glaube, es kann viel assistieren, aber komplett den Arzt ablösen oder den Radiologen oder den Neurologen wird es wahrscheinlich, denke ich, lange nicht, weil am Ende muss dann doch die Entscheidung in der Hand des Arztes bleiben. Also ich glaube, das dauert auf jeden Fall noch 50 Jahre mindestens.
Yeah, maybe replacing some techniques in the lab while, you know, everything is manual, where you're just repeating the same things that you know and you're not really thinking about it. Think about artificial intelligence replacing that kind of stuff, but even doctor, I don't think it's going to happen. You still need someone to talk to, right? You need someone who's going to comfort you. Like, you know, when you're going to the hospital, I think most of the time you're probably in shock, and you know, if someone's telling you you have cancer, you need that kind of empathy from the person telling you it's going to be okay or it's not going to be okay. But you need someone you can, you know, look at. I think you need something human.
The important thing is that the person is dealing with a person, so the person can understand not only the disease but his emotions. There is definitely a difference between a human being, a medical doctor, and an artificial intelligence. So I don't think so it can replace it. The major important thing is that we are the one who are creating this artificial intelligence, so always we would be a step higher than that particular artificial intelligence. That's what I think.
I don't think it will replace the doctor. I think there'll always be a need for human intervention and judgment in analysis of really complex cases. So my immediate reaction is I think doctors will be around for quite a while yet.
Looking at medical information, the computer can remember more and be less biased. And the computer actually, in looking at medical images, can see things much more readily and much more uniformly than a person does. So the pathologist that reads medical slides may have a problem and be displaced, whereas the invention of truly novel things, I think, will stay with people.